Hello my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. My name is Amy if you're brand new here, and as I said, I have a lot more time now that I'm staying home more, so I wanted to do another session of Q&A. The first question is by Jenna Van 983, wondering what you think about the Vanity PM from Louis Vuitton. I love the look of it, I really do, and I was so tempted, I was this close to pre-ordering it, but I knew that I will most likely get annoyed at the zipper of the bag because it goes around the bag. Although I did see a few unboxing videos that showed that it was a lot smoother than their regular Vanity from their toiletry section. So I know for a fact that the Vanity PM handbag one is a lot smoother. So that can definitely help. But even then, in general, I just don't favor zipper bags, just because unless it's a straight zipper where you can go back and forth really easily, just like my Gabrielle, especially because you have two zipper pulls, sometimes I feel like having two zipper pulls is actually more counterproductive, just because you have to pull it from both sides and, you know, pull it back from both sides to close it. So that's one reason why I didn't pre-order it. The other reason is because there is a little clochette, and then also the zipper pulls need to be centered in the front and the clochette really nicely kind of positioned in the front to look cute. Although it is an aesthetic issue, it is something that I think about as well, because when I'm out and about and I'm, you know, rushing through the cash registers and or just running around wanting to get something in and out of my bag, I will probably not take the time to center my zipper pulls and fix the little clochette tag in front. You know, I will probably not do that. Third of all is the little top handle. That top handle is really cute and I loved how they did it. I love that they have the straps attached to both sides of the bag instead of the top of the bag. But if you do put really heavy things in the bag, even though it is a small bag, you can still put heavier things inside, and it is pretty roomy actually from what I can see. It will kind of give that pull look on the top. It's also a concern in the long term. I just don't know if by pulling it, not pulling it, but by holding it from the top handle, that it will end up pulling too much on the canvas. And then I don't know what kind of wear and tear will create in the long term. Obviously, those are all just my opinion and my sort of thought process on what I don't like about the bag. I don't have the bag, so I don't really know for sure, but those are just things that I can think of that will annoy me, and that's why I did not go ahead and order it, because it is really cute. I have to say, I love the reverse mono, I love the chain strap, the details on it are really, really cute. In fact, my friend Gina, hi, she is still debating on whether she should get it. Like I always say in the past, every single bag has pros and every single bag has cons. If you can live with the cons of that particular bag, then chances are you're gonna be fine, because it's not gonna bother you tremendously. Then you're gonna like it, you're gonna love it, you're gonna use it. But if those cons do bother you and you know that for a fact that they will annoy you in the long term, then chances are you're gonna want to kind of not wear the bag as often in the long term, and then maybe eventually you will like not wear it at all. And that is what I want to avoid for myself. So that's just my two cents. Hopefully it was helpful. Like I said, it is really cute. If you really love it, go ahead, get it. But if any of the cons that I mentioned will really, really bother you, like deep down really, really bother you, then I would refrain from getting it, just because, yeah, you don't want to have buyer's remorse. The next question is by Stephanie. It's the questions that I got from my IG story when I asked you guys. What do you think of the small Vanity with classic chain? I'm assuming that you're talking about the Chanel one, because if you're talking about the LV one, I just told you exactly what I thought. So I'm assuming you're talking about the little tiny Vanity SLG from Chanel, the new one where it zips around from the top and then there's a chain where you can wear crossbody or on the shoulder. It's a super cute Vanity, and there's two different sizes. There's one that's tiny, and then there's one that's more decent size. I think it actually does fit a phone inside. That one I really like. I really like, even though it is a zip around, let me get to that. I've seen a couple of videos on people you know, unboxing it and also showing what fits. And what I really like about that one is that even if you do open it all the way, it doesn't fall off, like as in it doesn't tip over and fall off or anything like that. The price point is so good because you get the classic chain, classic Chanel chain, you get caviar leather, you get the CC logo, you get a beautiful burgundy interior if you get the black one. Of course, you can also get the navy one, which comes with a navy interior, I think. I've also seen other colors. I don't remember where I saw it, but I saw some that were pink. I think I saw a blue one. It's like so pretty. It's very simple, but the price point is so great that I feel like you cannot go wrong, especially if it does fit a phone. Online it says that the dimension is 6.6 inches across, and the iPhone, the max iPhone, at least the XS Max, I believe it's 6.2 inches, so technically it should fit in it, especially if you have a very thin case. So I really like it, I do. And I know that I may be contradicting myself because I just said earlier that I don't like the LV one. It's not that I don't like it, it's just that I won't get that one because I feel like with that one, zipping around it and also with the top handle, it's just not my... I just foresee some issues, at least with me using it. I just won't like the way that that one behaves, whereas the one from Chanel, I actually don't mind it for some reason. It almost feels like it's a novelty purchase. Very similar to my round clutch. Like I said, this is... a lot of people don't like this because you cannot fit a phone in it, but the way this one zips is really easy, is so smooth, and I actually figured out a way to close it really fast as well. I just hold it by the bottom. Don't even try to like try to fiddle around from the top. Just hold the bottom very lightly and then it will kind of do its thing pretty smoothly. And so that's how I feel about the little vanity from Chanel, just because, you know, it is a novelty item. It's such a good price point for Chanel, and at the end of the day, I'm a Chanel lover, so I do favor, and I am a bit more biased when it comes to Chanel. I almost like everything that Chanel makes, you know, except the really out there ones, but I almost like anything from Chanel. And to be very honest, I tried to get that little vanity, but I think in Canada only Toronto ordered it, Toronto flagship, and I tried calling them and they only had ordered one, I was told, and there was already a client who paid for it and pre-ordered it a long time ago. So the next question by J Hart Slux: what is your most practical Chanel bag? I'm actually having a little hard time choosing just one because... anyway, I want to show you three. I know I'm cheating because you're asking for one, but let me talk about them anyway. So I'm showing these two, so my Chanel 19, my bucket bag, as well as my Gabrielle. So those are the three that I feel like are my most practical ones. Let me go through each of them because I feel like it may be different for you. So I am someone who is a light packer. I don't really need very much when I use my handbags. I tend to carry very, very little. Let's start with my smallest one. This is the Gabrielle small size, and the reason why I feel like this is one of my most practical bags is because once you have everything in it, and because it stands up so well and the bottom is structured, everything stands up so well, they don't move around inside, and the fact that it's a really easy zipper, you just straight go down or straight up. It's really easy to get in and out of it. Even my phone, even though it doesn't have any exterior pockets, my phone usually just slides in, and I just usually put it on either side, but usually the side that doesn't have this pocket. So I just put it on the zipper side, and it's so easy to get in and out of this. It's so easy to get anything out and putting it back without having to play too much Tetris. I just like it a lot. And plus, this bag goes with almost everything. It's a little bit more casual, but not to the point where it's too casual, so it pretty much works with all my outfit, and whether I use the black one or the burgundy one, I use my black one a lot more, so I should have shown the black one, but whether I use this color or the other color, they just both work so well in terms of the functionality, the style, definitely works for me. I know it doesn't work for everybody because most people carry a lot more than I do, but for me, this bag is just fantastic. It's just enough space inside that I don't feel like I need to downsize. And I like that this bag is taller too because I can always put my sunglasses on top. Let's talk about the bucket bag. I know that bucket bags are seasonal, so the one that you have may not be exactly the same one, but what I like about this one is that it's caviar, so it's super carefree. I've worn this when it was raining. It's perfectly fine. I love the fact that it's a bigger bag, so this will fit a bit more than the previous bag, so it will, you know, accommodate more on days that I actually need to bring a few more things. For example, if I have certain appointments, I have that ability to fit more inside. I also love the fact that it has two different shoulder options. I mean, one shoulder option and one carry option. And then so it's one of the best bags in my opinion. Things do get mixed up inside a little bit just because it's a little black hole. It's not a terrible black hole. You could always pull this down and really yank it open to see everything and grab whatever you need. But I typically don't really adjust or readjust this. I just leave it be, kind of like this. So I do work with a smaller opening in general, and that can just be a little deterrent when it's really full and you're trying to find that one thing. So it's still a great bag, but it can get a little messy inside, whereas with the Gabrielle, it doesn't get messy at all. Everything is always in its right place because it's so compact, right? And then whatever you stand up inside, it will just stay in its place. The reason why I wanted to show my 19 bag, and in fact I have stuff inside because I was just using it, the reason why I'm showing the 19 bag is because unlike the other two bags, which is more structured, this one is not structured. So in terms of capacity, this one is very similar to the bucket bag, but what I like about this one is that once you open it, everything is at a glance. So no black holes, very easy to get in and out of it. I love the flap feature. I always love a good flap bag. I love this chain because you do that or you hold it by hand. Holding it by hand is one of my favorite ways. It just looks super cool. The shoulder strap, I also did mention that I do use it once in a while, but this part is still kind of new, I suppose. It hasn't molded to my shoulders yet, so it does fall off when I'm wearing a big coat. I imagine that when I'm wearing like a, I don't know, maybe like a bare shoulder top or like a thin blazer, that it would stay on better, and especially if it starts molding to my shoulder a bit better, then it will get better over time. But I do like the having the option of a crossbody when I want it to be hands-free. But in general, this bag is just fantastic. And even though it is lambskin, so this bag comes in two different, well, more than two, but it usually comes in either lambskin or goat skin in terms of leather. Mine is lambskin because the season where I got it is in lambskin. This lambskin is super durable. It's very luxe. I don't know if you can tell, like you can probably tell from the camera. It's very luxe. It's very soft, but it's treated in a way that it still preserves the softness of lambskin, but it doesn't scratch as easily. I'm not gonna do it, I'm not gonna try it, but it just doesn't scratch as easily. I know it is not because I'm not super paranoid with it anymore. I always say, I take care of my bags and I'm careful when I use it, but I don't have to baby it to the extent that I thought I would have to if it was a regular lambskin. So I am a huge fan of the 19, especially in the small size. With the small size, you won't have much sagging problem. I'm not even using an organizer at the moment. I only use the organizer when I store it. Actually, that's not only, but I use the organizer when I feel like it and also when I store it, basically. But when I want to have all the space possible in this bag, I don't use the organizer just because then you have way more space, because the organizer still takes up space. Because I have the small size, and then also it doesn't open up all the way out, it has a bit of an inch of stitch on each side. I don't quite use the back pocket as much, because while my phone fits and while I can still use it, I just use it for things to slip in really quickly. So receipts, right now I have this inside, so I don't quite use it as much in the back, but it is a good size pocket, especially if you have the larger size. But yeah, parking stubs, anything like that, super handy to have a back pocket. But otherwise, I just use the main compartment. It's such a pleasure to use this bag. And with this leather, because it is not a structured bag, you can carry it this way, you can bunch it up. I truly feel that these three bags are my most practical Chanel bags, and they each, I use them in a different setting, I suppose. So the 19, I prefer using it when it's not raining because it's still lambskin. I know that rain will dry off well because I've tried it, it's fine, but I just don't prefer it. When it rains, I like this one. When it doesn't rain, I like the Chanel 19. And when I really don't need a bigger bag, because these are still for me kind of a size small to medium, whereas the Gabrielle is more like a mini. So when I really don't need much, then I prefer my Gabrielle. And I should probably also mention that my minis are practical, except that I know that minis are so constricting in terms of what they can fit. That's why I didn't include it. But otherwise, the Caviar minis are so practical as well. Tough choice. I really can't choose. Like I said, that's why I own all three, and I can't choose. Sorry. Next question. Chell 0330, which one would you pick, Dior 30 Montaigne or My Lady Dior? When I chat with my friends, I always said that between the Dior Book Tote Small and the 30 Montaigne, I would choose the 30 Montaigne, but between the 30 Montaigne and the Lady Dior, I would choose the Lady Dior. Even though in general, I never really wear any one bag every day in my collection because I rotate them all the time, I still want to think of it in that scenario. So when it comes to the My Lady or even the Lady Dior, I feel like because they're not everyday bags, I might, oh, I don't know, it's so hard. I might gravitate towards the 30 Montaigne more, just because that bag, I mean, it's beautiful, but it's also the fact that I feel like it can be an everyday bag. And I love that the strap can be doubled so that if you want to go from day to night, that you can do it. I know you can do it with My Lady Dior as well. Yeah, I'm completely conflicted, probably confused you even further, but that's how I feel. Like, until I see the combo, it's gonna be hard for me to make a decision right now. But if I were to base it on my collection, the bag that will be the most differentiating would be the Lady Dior, because I have nothing like the Lady Dior, whereas the 30 Montaigne is more similar to a lot of the bags that I already own. So perhaps I would go with the Lady Dior first, whether it's My Lady or the Mini Lady. But yeah, I guess that's my answer. I would most likely go with My Lady Dior more or first, just because I don't have anything like that at the moment. Rites of beauty. As a lover of mini bags, what are your tips for carrying less? My main tip is to carry what you absolutely need and to not carry what you don't need or may not necessarily need. So for instance, what I must bring out all the time is my phone. So that's number one. If I'm going out by myself, then I will need keys. However, if I go out with my husband, then I won't bring my keys because he can bring the keys. So if I can eliminate my keys, then that's like one, like that's this much space that you can save, right? So it depends on the situation. Wallets, you can downsize to something like this. So I always just use a card holder now. I have a full-size wallet, which I never even use. If you really, really, really need to downsize, I would just take out my driver's license and I would just take out my credit card if I really needed to downsize this much. Otherwise, I'll just take my card case because it will have cash, it will have my insurance, it will have my credit card and my ID, and really that's all you need. You can buy really beautiful wallets with really beautiful material, really intricate designs, but they can be bulky. And so if you can live with a card holder, you're set, especially with nowadays, this day and age where everything is modernized, you can pay with a debit card or a credit card, you really, really very seldomly need an actual full-size wallet. So unless you're traveling, in which case you may need actual cash and coins, I would just be bringing that. Usually what I also need is a lip balm. I always bring. And then I guess nowadays you want to bring hand sanitizer because you know why. Essentially, that's all you need. If you can fit this in a bag, then you're okay. That's how I downsize, and that's how I end up not really needing bigger bags, and that's why I end up buying mostly smaller bags. And the fact that my Chanel 19 is already a bigger bag, I still chose it in the smallest size because it will fit all this plus a bit more. So let me show you what I have in there that I don't always bring with me, but I sometimes bring just because maybe I'm out and about a bit longer, or if I'm going somewhere special and I want to just have it in case. Bag hanger is definitely one of them. If I am only wearing a very mini size bag, then I do not bring my bag hanger because I most likely don't need to hang it. I could just put it on my lap when I sit down. So this will come with me if I use a bigger bag, such as my 19 or my bucket bag, then I'll bring this. Another thing to save space is to, instead of using actual pouches, so instead of like your O case or your mini pochette from LV, I just use this. These are just one of those like almost like gift things that you sometimes get with jewelry or whatever. I just use this as my pouch. So if you have little, like tiny little things that you want to fit inside and you don't want it to float around your bag, so I can put my bag hanger in it. I used to bring floss so I can fit my floss in it. You can put your lip product in it. Whatever else that's small, you can just put it in a pouch like this. These pouches take no space whatsoever and it's pretty flexible, so you're saving a lot of space by not having an actual mini pochette or a little old case from Chanel. What else do I have in here? Okay, so I have a coin purse, I have my AirPods, and I have some mints. So these are non-essential for me. I bring them sometimes, but they're non-essential. AirPod, I only bring it if I feel like I need to wait around. So if I'm going to an appointment and I need to wait around, then I'll bring AirPods so that I can discreetly listen to a video or whatever, or a podcast. So I bring that sometimes, not all the time. Coin purse, I bring if I know that I need it for parking or for tipping. I only bring it in those instances. If I know that I don't need coins, I do not bring it. Because these things are heavy sometimes and they can take up pretty much a lot of, well, this one doesn't take up that much space, but still, anything that you add to it adds to it, right? So the more you eliminate, the more you can downsize. I like ginger mints and I still don't bring it all the time. I bring it on like, you know, road trips just in case I get, you know, road sick, or I don't know, just when I feel like I need it, I guess. But I do not bring it all the time. I only bring it on longer trips, or like if I'm out and about the entire day, then I will bring it. But if I'm really only out and about for a short period of time, or if I'm just going out to get groceries, you know, these type of things, then I don't. I just pretty much downsize to, I mean, this is usually all I carry. I do not bring makeup with me. Usually I either wear makeup or I don't wear makeup. And if I already wore makeup, then all I need is a lip product. I don't really need anything else. I don't really ever touch up my face. Especially nowadays, you do not want to touch your face. Do not touch your face. Victoria over Chris, I think that's your name. What is the best tote bag? Since you didn't mention for what occasion, I'm just gonna assume you mean the best tote bag for everyday use. So in my opinion, the best tote can be none other than the Neverfull. And the medium size is pretty much the most universal one because it's not too big, but it's not too small. So this would be my best tote bag choice for everyday use. If I know that I'm gonna be running a lot of errands, say if I go to the pharmacy and I have to go to like pick up something somewhere, usually I bring my tote for those days, because instead of asking for a bag everywhere I go, I just throw it in my tote, because with the pharmacy you can throw supplements, prescriptions, even when I buy skincare I just throw it in my bag. So I love using my tote that way, because it just fits everything and I don't need to have like a million different small bags. Plus the Neverfull is still one of the more affordable bags from LV. I mean, they are really expensive now, but they are still one of the most affordable bags, and get a lot of bag for your money, and they are very durable. I've never really heard of anyone having major issues with the Neverfull because they're just so well made. The straps, even though they're thin, they're very durable, and yeah, what can I say? It's just one of the best totes. That is why I recommend it. But if you were to ask me the best tote for travel, I will definitely say that it's the Longchamp tote. Mine is a limited edition, that's why this is a coated canvas, and it's waterproof as well. So this bag is one of the greatest travel bags because it's super light. Right now I have an organizer inside and I still have a few things from my trip to Seattle the other week, but it's just one of the best bags because this fits right on top of your carry-on if you're traveling internationally, but you can also just bring it on a weekend trip and just throw everything in there. They are relatively inexpensive, you know, one of those simple, most basic le pliage will cost you under 200, I believe, and if you go for a more limited edition one, it's, you know, a bit more, but they look a bit more different than the rest of them, which is, you know, either way you cannot go wrong with the Longchamp. And because with the Longchamp you get the zipper, you get extra security for travel. That's why I feel like if you are gonna travel, and plus when you travel, the last thing you want to think about is someone getting inside your bag, or, you know, sometimes when you're really tired, the last thing you want to think about is trying to baby your bag. Let's say if I were to carry the Vachetta one, I don't want to get it dirty from, you know, liquids and drinks. And even if I were to use my one that has the coated leather, I still don't want to scuff the body of the bag. So like, I travel with this, but only on like short trips maybe, and then maybe like road trips I will travel with this. But seriously, in terms of travel, best tote is none other than the Longchamp, in my opinion. Last question is by Babe Lisa. What do you do for a living? So I already mentioned, or already answered that question in the past, so perhaps you didn't see that. Basically, I work in the IT industry. In the past, I was in consulting. I was also a software engineer at one point. I was also a quality assurance. What else did I do? I don't remember. Project management was the latest. I did study computer science. I graduated with a bachelor's of computer science. Why am I getting tongue twist? Yeah, that's it. It's not that interesting. I don't even know. Well, I know and I don't know. I guess back then when I chose to study computer science, I just didn't know what I wanted to do. So I just chose something. I wasn't interested in like applied sciences. I was not interested in, you know, health science. I was kind of interested in commerce and business, but not to the point where I feel like to make a career out of it. So I really did not know what I wanted to do. And I loved fashion, but I was also too logical to get into fashion school just because I knew that I was capable of studying, like, you know, the more mainstream subjects. I don't know how to word it properly. I thought really hard and long about getting into fashion school or even like interior design school back then, because I think I'm more creative, but I'm also technical, so it's hard to explain. And so I think my parents were against that. They were not forcing me to not do it, I guess, but they were also not happy about it. So, and I guess I'm also a bit logical myself. I knew that I wanted to make a living out of whatever I studied, and also I wanted to be independent. I was already independent back then, so I wanted to continue to be independent, so I chose computer science. There was really no other explanation other than I knew that computer technology is what was going on back then, and it's still going on right now. Like, it's due to high technology and due to advances in technology that things are getting so accessible, globalization, availability of information. I just knew that it was an industry that was booming. Thank you so much for asking them. Again, I welcome you to suggest, you know, different other video topics that you want me to film, because I definitely have a little bit more time than usual since I'm staying home a lot now and I work from home. So feel free to suggest any other things that you want to request or want me to talk about. If you're brand new to my channel, please do not forget to subscribe. I hope that you got value out of this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, comment down below to say hi, and I'll talk to you guys again all very soon. Bye!